Denmark was going to be the 10th country I ever went to. So far in my life, I had been to 9 different countries. In order, they are the Netherlands, Germany, Belgium, France, Luxembourg, Monaco, Italy for like 30 seconds, that's a fun story, Estonia, and the United Kingdom. I had been waiting for that 10th one for at least 5 or 6 years, and for this trip, for 8 years. It was always going to be Denmark. Now, the original idea was that we went to Legoland, but because it took 2 years longer than it was supposed to, my trip got upgraded to basically the entirety of Denmark, and my dad suggested we could also cross the bridge to Malmö in Sweden. That sounded great to me because it meant 2 new countries, bumping my total up to 11. When my dad and I planned the whole trip out, we originally ended in Malmö, but then we'd have to drive all the way back home in 1 day. That did not entirely sound feasible, so we reevaluated our choices, and then my dad said the magical words, "What if we do it the opposite way?" So on Monday, we had a quick breakfast and immediately jumped in the car, because we were going to drive all the way to Sweden today.
Road again. Where are we headed? We're going to Sweden!
Denmark is still the 10th country, but we were going to skip most of it for the time being. First, we still had a bit of Germany left to go through, which included more Ausfahrt and the channel from the North Sea to the East Sea, which was, in my opinion, the prettiest thing we'd seen so far on this trip. Then we got to a sign saying the next Ausfahrt was going to be the final Ausfahrt in Germany.
Want ik wil niet de grens missen. Nou, daar hebben we de laatste Ausfahrt. Dus als het goed is, zou het hier ergens moeten. Rusley. Staat er nu ook al in het Deens onder. Grensovergang 1000 meter. Nou.
Oh, Denemarken, 1 kilometer.
Auf Wiedersehen, Ed van Morgen. Oh no. Maar dit zal het wel zijn. Hè? Maar Denemarken zit toch ook niet in de Europese Unie? Ik heb geen idee. Geen Nederlanders. Ik zie daar al wel een vlag. Ik weet niet of die op de camera staat, maar ik zie een vlag. Ook een Zweedse en een Finse. Er zit ook een vlag van IJsland. Midlertidig boom. Dat zal deze wel zijn.
Boom.
Oh. Ja. Boom. Nou, hier staat het bord. Denemarken. Volgens mij zijn we er.
So that was it. We were in Denmark.
69.
We kept driving for a few more kilometers, admiring the view, before taking a quick break to breathe some Danish air and, in the case of my dad, Danish coffee.
Die moet wel even een video, hè? Middelfart, ja. Yeah. Nou. We hebben een koffie en een blikje cola gekocht en het kostte 42 kronen.
That might sound like a lot, but it was like 5.5 euros. Danish kronas aren't worth a lot. We did kind of make fun of Middelfart there, but what we didn't realize at the time was that Middelfart is the first city immediately over the bridge to the first island. So when we saw a bridge coming in the distance, I started filming.
Ik heb ook eigenlijk geen idee waar we nu precies zitten. Middelfart was al de hoek om, toch? Dan zou het kunnen dat dit gewoon al een brug is naar het eiland waar Odense op is. Dat moet ik zeker filmen. Middelfart! Yeah. Wow. Oh wow. Ik hoop dat het te zien is. Ik kan het niet zien, want de zon is te zwaar.
Ik kan het scherm niet zien. Oh, dit is heel mooi.
For the people who don't know, Denmark consists of the mainland part, which is attached to Germany, and a bunch of islands, including Greenland, which we didn't go to. Two of the islands are connected by bridges to the mainland, each other, and Sweden. This meant we had to cross all of them. We just had the first one, and the rest of the island was really boring, but then I checked Google Maps, and we were really close to the second bridge.
Knutthoven.
Sydalavater.
Ja, dat is hem hoor.
Zo, dat is net er.
Ja, daar moeten we overheen.
We hadden ook een trein over kennelijk. Ja. Die moet ook in de rest van Denemarken komen.
Ja.
Hier zit hij letterlijk gewoon in het midden van de zee. Hier zit verder niks.
Ja, een beetje wel, ja. Alleen dan nog erger.
Dit eiland is wel mooi, though. Okay. Ja, dus nu zijn we wel weer op land.
Alle vogels zitten in dit meertje hier.
Zeker. And now we get the big bridge.
Brug.
De brug knippert. Oh ja. Wat zou dat betekenen?
Het is dat er een vliegtuig
tegenaan moet vliegen. Oh ja. Feeling fine, this party is drying up. I'm looking fine, not even trying.
Very moist.
Waarschijnlijk als ik deze hele brug film, dan gaat het heel cool worden als ik het versnel.
Oh,
weet je wel, ja.
En dan hebben we er zo meteen nog een naar beneden.
It did cost money to cross the bridge, and we were in the line to pay with a card, which was labeled kort, which is also the Dutch word for short.
Express kort contant. Dat is pinnenhok, want er staat een pinpas bij.
Ja, okay.
Oh, kort. Ja, okay.
And my dad and I had a conversation that I unfortunately did not record, but my dad made a joke about the line not being short but long, and then I said, just like my penis, eh? My dad thought it was funny. But we were on the final island now, on our way to Copenhagen, where there was one more bridge to get to Sweden. We stopped real quickly for lunch and a toilet, and it was right next to this beautiful lake. Then we hopped back in the car on the way to Copenhagen, and I decided to grab my Switch and continue where I left off yesterday with Paper Mario the Origami King until we got there. Arriving in Copenhagen, we passed the last exit in Denmark and went through a couple of tunnels before emerging directly onto the bridge to Malmö.
Oh, daar komt het bord. Seria. Ik weet niet of die scherp was, maar ik hoop het. Ten hol van de radio. And everything gets in the way. Seems you cannot be replaced. Yeah, boys. Welcome to Sweden.
We could have gone straight to our hotel, but we had plenty of time, so we decided to keep going for now to one of the places I wanted to visit, which was the southernmost point in Sweden. It was called Smugahook, and it was right next to a harbor with a lighthouse, and you saw about as much as you'd expect to be able to see. There were a couple more viewpoints, but you still weren't able to see much more than water, although you could see a bit more of the rest of Sweden from this one. There was also this statue of what could be a siren, maybe? It said it on a sign, but I didn't read it. After spending some time at Smugahook, we drove back to Malmö and checked into our hotel. After that, we took a stroll through Malmö and tried to find an Italian restaurant, which we did, on a square called the David's Hall. It cost 555 Swedish krona, which is like 55 euros because Swedish krona are worth even less. We continued our walk and tried to find the harbor, which took way longer than it needed to, but we eventually made it to a field where you had a very good view of Denmark and the bridge, and it led to a beach, which had the same thing. There was also this twisty tower and a pier leading to some building which we had no idea what it was, but it had two rainbow flags on it, so of course we checked it out. Inside was a bar and what we assumed was some sort of swimming pool. It also had a sign saying something about queer, but it was in Swedish, so no clue what it said. We had left our swimming trunks at the hotel room, so we just decided to go back for the day. Back in the hotel room, we were watching the last half of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom with Swedish subtitles on the television, but my dad kept falling asleep near the end, so when the movie finished, I suggested maybe we should go to bed. But she moves like lightning. And she counts to three. Then she turns out all the lights and says she's coming for me. And I put your hands up. When my dad and I planned the whole trip out, we originally ended with it. For the people who don't know, Denmark consists of the mainland part, which is attached, and a bunch of islands. I made a typo in my script there. Islands. A bunch of islands. Good job.